All right, we want to continue with the with part B. So we want to take the other part of this retrieving information from data, but we wanted to solve this problem first. In the previous video, we were able to load data from command. I will repeat this load data from command, and I will try to do that of Excel. Then we'll run some kind of queries for today's lesson, which says retrieving information from table. So here I've already created a database called Corona instead of CoronaDB, so it doesn't conflict with the previous one we created. So here I have the txt file here with me, Corona 2020. I've already copied the path here. You can rewrite, you can type the file name, the folder, the location, which constitute the path. So here I type load.
So I have to use the
yes, of course. I haven't made it active. Thank you. Use Corona. If you check, it has no tables. In fact, it has no tables. Okay. So you create table. I told you we've already created the table in the command that will create the table in what? In a text file, in a txt file. Please copy this and paste. So it will create a table called Corona cases for you. Okay. So copy and paste this. That's what we have here. So if you show table now, you see this table, but this table is what is blank. It has no instances. Corona cases, you see it's blank. So let's load the data into it. Are we understanding? From where are we loading the data? We don't have already data has been given in an electronic format, so you don't rewrite. Rather, you do what? You load. So you now say load data local in file, in one word, then the path, okay, into what? Table. Then the table name, is what? Corona _ cases, right? So now the path has been copied from the Windows Explorer. I will just paste the path here. Sorry. Let me copy it again. After copying, I copied something. Okay. Corona. Sorry. Load data local in file path into table, and then the table name is Corona cases. Okay, so we paste the path here, then you press enter. Thank you. Backward slashes. Yes, it is now loading. After changing the backward slash, we told you here that it's Windows who understands backward slashes while separating between the root directory, the folder, the directory, and the subdirectories, and the what, and the Windows. It is done now. It is able to do it within 15 seconds, and the record it has worked on was 916,801. Okay, and there were warnings. These warnings, actually, it means it couldn't copy these lines. So if you count what you have here, you know, if you select what you have, it's going to. All right, this is select from Corona cases, right? it will keep running for a very large number of time. It will be running this way because the lines are many, right? It tells you that it has entered. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
So you can press Control C to stop it. Control C. It has stopped it. And it is back to command prompt. So you have to go back to the MySQL Easyway route. Then you supply your password and what. Okay? So do you know we can count instead of we? What do you think this will do? It will count the number of rows. Okay, I haven't select database. I say Corona, right? So count now. This is what you have. The number of things it has inserted. So if you check from Excel data, there are lot of continent, lot of whatever. Let's now start putting in conditions. Of course, we want to select Betwire location because let's select our country. Because if you check here, this Asia, you see what Afghanistan. If you go to where Africa is, you see you're going to come across Nigeria, okay? So let's check for Nigeria here. It counted, right? 5,729. But then let's see it. We don't want it to count. Let's view what we are doing. Okay? So it will keep going as well. But it's not as much as the first select command. This is 5,000 plus. You see, you are putting in what condition. So at every case, there are number of total cases. So you can sum some, you can do any kind of query you want to do. While it is doing this, let's quickly create another table and insert from Excel. This is what I want to do. This we haven't done it with batch A. Okay, so this where we create the first table. I'll copy this and I'll paste it somewhere. Okay, let me create this table as Corona inside a database Corona. Is it possible? It is. Copy, Control C. I just stopped it so it doesn't waste our time. Okay. So within the same, because if you say show databases here, show tables here, you see only one table, right? So let's create another table called this. So now if you show it, it gives you two tables. Another table called Corona, and the database is also called Corona, okay? So let's go to the Excel sheet here. This is the list of what we have in the Excel sheet. Okay, let me take it up. All right, are we getting it? So I can press Control A to select what? Select all, and then after that, Control A. When I select this way, you know, the very first row here contains what? Column names, cell levels, or column names rather. Is it? So you should take note of that. It is different from when you select without that. So you don't allow this, the system should not try to insert that. So then I'll go to data, then I'll move to MySQL for Excel, and then I will check here. You know, we created one connection here. For those of you who are new, if you want to create connection here for the first time, these are connections already created. Come over here, click on new connection, give out the name of the connection here. Let's say Corona DB connection. So you understand what we are doing, right? Okay, then come over here. All these are correct, but please check your MySQL, the MySQL you are using, MySQL you are using, the port number. If you are using port number 3306, you supply it here. If you are using 3307, 3309, 3308, supply it there. Okay, if you don't have it, pardon, if you don't have any other database installed, any other MySQL installed in your system, that means you are using the default, which is 3306. Yes. So then you supply the password. Already, I mean, root, then you supply password here. I supplied my password. Then please test the connection from here before you move. Connection is okay, right? Okay. Then you click on what?
Okay.
So if you check here, you see Corona connection here created for you. Look at it. Double click it. And then come over. These are list of databases, okay? So we're looking for what? Corona, right? That's the database we're going to use, Corona. Look at it. Okay? Double click it, or you click on next. So we have two tables inside it, is it? Of course, we have two tables. Corona cases there, but we are dealing with Corona. Then you click on what? Click on it and click on append Excel data for table. So wait. Which one takes longer time? So in the table, in the question, we ask you to present your proofs of which one is the best. But then, you know, if you are giving us, there has to be some business. Based on what? Are you talking based on reliability? Are you talking based on speed? Do you understand?
Yes.
So please look at, come over here. We say first row contains what? Names, column names. Does your data in the data sheets you have, in the worksheet you have, do you, you know, highlights include column names? What is this here?
Continent.
It's continent, but what is it? Is it not column name? It's not a data. You don't, you know, it is a table name. It is a column name. So if you have done that, you click on this. Otherwise, you leave it as it is. Please look at how it, you understand?
Yes.
How? You know, when you click, it brings column names like this.
Yes.
If you deselect it, it doesn't. Of course, it gives you this. If you click on this, you understand. Then allow this automatic mapping. Then you click on what? Append. Column mapping incomplete. No. There's a problem somewhere. Column mapping incomplete. The column you selected and the column inside it are not complete, are not same. Probably the name of the column we supplied or something. I would have just selected some, so we test it. If it works, then this is taking longer time than loading from TXT. You know, I told you the other time, if you're loading from TXT, the operation is being carried out between only two things, two entities, your MySQL database server and the TXT. Of course, there is operating system is always there. There's no application that runs without operating system. But in here, the operation is being carried out within how many? Within three entities. Your MySQL, the Excel application, and the API. So that's why it's taking time this way. And sometimes it complains about merging, about mapping about all that. So that is it. This could take longer time. We'll just stop the video here. Try it. I believe it will work. Or you select only portion of the rules and try it. Thank you.